IVM. कृपया ध्यान दीजिए, the language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen, yaar, don't be so conservative.
Okay, it's time for conversations on Cyrus Says. But before that, I have to tell you, I've been struggling with the IPL because I go to sleep normally at 9, 9:15, living in a woman's hostel. You know, that's the kind of life I have. However, now because of the damn IPL and the cracker game that I had yesterday, I've had no sleep because I just couldn't stop. I had to watch it. And I've realized now after about 20 years of marriage that cricket has completely replaced my wife. My nocturnal activities are and going to be restricted to the game of cricket. Sad to say, from my perspective, but my wife's off the hook. She's really happy. Who's not off the hook is Niharika. In fact, she's here to celebrate with us. Terrible segue to bring her into the show. But before that, let's go into a break.
Janice, what do you think couples did before TV was invented?
I don't know. Go for walks on the beach, long drives, fancy dinners, have more sex maybe?
But what did we do when we decided to move in together? We debated between the Chromecast and the Fire Stick.
We gave up on sleeping early so we could stay up watching true crime shows.
We got ourselves 3 cat babies.
And basically became the cutest couch potatoes around.
Okay then.
In case you guys still haven't got it, we are a TV crazy, Netflix loving, binge watching Mr. and Mrs.
I'm Anirudh Guha.
I'm Janice Iquera.
And if like us, you snort TV for breakfast, lunch and dinner, this is the podcast for you.
Tune in every Thursday on the IVM podcast app or wherever it is that you get your podcast from. This is
Mr.
and Mrs.
Binge Watch.
Congratulations. Let me introduce you. I talk too fast and too much, so anytime you want to interrupt, please do. And I've written lots of references somewhere, but I've lost the page. So what I do know is 10 years of Instagram, and you are the strategic manager, head, high commissioner, El Supremo, omnipotent presence. Am I right?
Not really, but hey Cyrus, hi, I'm Niharika. I work with Instagram, definitely not El Supremo, but a part of the partnership team. And we are celebrating 10 years of Instagram next week. So very excited to chat all things Instagram.
Okay, listen, but before we go forward, I have to ask you, your surname is Pandey and my Hindi teacher's name was Mr. Pandey. Are you by any chance, did your dad work as an educationist in South Mumbai in the 80s and 90s?
No.
Because he caned me. Niharika, he caned me with a ruler.
Listen, please don't use that as any, like, don't try and, like, you know, clear any old Pandey sins. There are many Pandeys. So
oh, there's so many.
Be kind. And typically the Hindi teachers are Pandey with a Y. I'm Pandey with a E, if that helps, because that's Kumaoni.
What's the logic between that? If your Hindi teacher is a Pandey with a Y?
There is a logic. I mean, a lot of the Pandeys typically are with a Y. See, I have to always clarify because my surname is without the Y. So I've grown up like always making that clarification. So just in case it saves me from you, like, you know, trying to not, like I said.
It tells us so much about your personality that you live within your means. You don't want that extra Y, that ostentatious display of extraness.
Yes, Pandey. Exactly.
Hardik Pandey and Krunal Pandey to note. Of course, Chulbul Pandey we shouldn't bring up because I suppose that would change the course of the game completely. All right. So let's begin. We want to talk about your life and all. That's what our show is all about. We basically were like the NCB, except they are looking at drugs. We're just looking at what you've done with your life, which is what they're looking at as well in a sense. I want to segue there for a second and just think about the great work we're doing in times of COVID. Having caught 3 hardened criminals like Sarah, Shraddha and Deepika for smoking hash once in 2017, I think all our troubles are over. This nation is healing as we speak. We're all good. Back to you.
Yes.
So 10 years of Insta. Let's begin with that. Congratulations.
Yeah, I mean, it's very exciting. I think overall, you know, we've been pretty excited about how Instagram has been growing in India. And 10 years is a fairly big milestone, I guess, in any company's journey. But I think for Instagram specifically, it's kind of also 10 years of culture because a lot of firsts happen on Instagram. And I think anybody who's sort of seen the 10-year journey would see the kind of trends that have broken out, the kind of, you know, new things, a lot of the Insta firsts, the fact that you're Instagram official, a lot of those things have come in. So we were working out and just looking at what were some big milestones. And I think you can almost track the journey of pop culture, right? Because if you look at the last 10 years, Instagram has been very, very critical in defining that. So yeah, I've been with Instagram for about a year now. I've been with Facebook for about 3 years. But I think even in India.
I thought it's like Coke and Pepsi. You don't mention all this together.
No. Family of apps, Cyrus, now we mention.
Really?
Yeah. Full. Every time you open Instagram or like other apps in the family of apps, you will see.
The alliances are formed.
Facebook, you will see that. That's part of our branding now.
And management can quickly walk from Facebook office headquarters straight to Instagram headquarters without a problem.
No, so the offices are in the same sort of vicinity, but the teams do function fairly independently. They're different brands. So from that perspective, they have their own journey and their own people. But yeah, they can walk in. We are nice to them. So,
but, it's amazing 10 years nowadays because most companies, thanks to COVID, et cetera, will not last maybe more than a year in the near future. 10 years is a lot in the modern context. It's not a joke, especially with the way tech keeps changing and these social institutions keep changing.
Yeah.
And all the new guy comes on the block. And, it's almost like songs. And the old song is just pushed out. I feel like that. I'm an old song myself. It's personified.
But you're keeping it fresh. Yeah, you're like keeping it fresh. That's the whole thing, right? You have to keep adapting.
So, that's hair coloring, which my 78-year-old mother has on her desk, and I just had nothing to do. So, by the way, she grooms me, as you can see. I look a lot like her now. There's hardly any difference. She looks a little younger, in fact. It's better skin. Niharika, before we get into your journey, let's talk about Instagram. I have some complaints. Can I just...
Please. Yes, go ahead.
Because, you've created a whole generation of idiots as well. I mean, if you don't mind me saying, like my friends who send me ridiculous Instas in the morning, I woke up, my dog's tail. Why? And then 10:32 p.m. toilet,
They want to share. So listen,
how do we stop that? How do we get rid of these people and yet keep your numbers?
The idea is that Instagram is a place for expression. And if people want to express themselves by sharing what they had for lunch, then so be it. If they want to express themselves by showcasing some cool thing they did, we give you an opportunity for that as well. So I think, no judgment on how you want to express yourself or what you want to do, but it is genuinely a place to connect, right? So if your friends want to share, Cyrus, it goes to show like how maybe deeply they want you to be part of their lives. Like they're sending it to you, right? They want you to know. So that's awesome.
Could we have an app where we could just give a thumbs up and never have to see the video or play ever, Because mostly it'll be that until some relative dies. That's the only time it'll backfire.
We do, by the way, give a lot of controls. So in case you do want to like limit comments or limit like who can DM you, you can do that. So just FYI, you can limit who DMs you if you don't want like a barrage.
Yeah, Erica, I should have told you in the beginning. Sorry to keep interrupting. But I still send cards to people like happy birthday, go to the post office, put it in that thing and all that. So, I have stamps. I'm a stamp collector. So I don't know. Maybe if you have a grandfather or something like that, maybe we could exchange notes. But other than that, it's really hard for me. And around me are my 13-year-old and 17-year-old kids who, their disdain and contempt they have for me and my generation is just, it's like racism. It's institutionalized. I don't even feel pain. Because I'll tell her, look, I've got something with cricket folk and you just, oh God, you idiot. It's like that. Those reactions. So now it's just normal. It's par for the course as far as I'm concerned. Again, let's not talk about me. I have my own shows. Let's talk about you. Let's now go back and look at why Niharika Pandey landed up in Instagram and you're doing great things here, I hope. I'm sure. Tell us a little bit about yourself. Where did it all start? How did you become part of this entire network, barrage?
Yeah, sure. So I have, like I said earlier, I am in Gurgaon right now, but I've grown up in Delhi. I've sort of...
How sweet. You quickly want to point out, look, I'm in Gurgaon, but I grew up in Delhi. I like that.
It's the same thing.
That's a prejudice of sorts. I say I'm a big Delhi fan? I mean, lots of fun, but I'm a big Delhi-Gurgaon fan. Love the people. I feel most comfortable there. I think one day if I could, I'd settle down there. They're like me, brash, loud, overconfident, cocky, all the things that I like in people and don't have to deliver but pretend to. So I'm very comfortable. I'm not one of those guys who goes to Delhi and says, I miss Mumbai. God, I hate Mumbai. Don't start me off about Mumbai.
Which is refreshing to hear from somebody in Bombay. So, but yes, I've been...
Mumbai people talk badly about Delhi? Have you seen the difference in the roads? I mean, Delhi, it's a road. In Mumbai, it's maybe something. Just walk slowly and hope you don't die. It's like that.
Depending on the month you're in. Yeah. So yes, very much in Delhi, enjoying the roads. Also growing up, I studied journalism. And
where did you grow up? Panchil Park? I have cousins.
Okay, that's really uncanny because I did grow up in Panchil
Park. What are you saying? So me and my cousin Ashish, every summer I used to go with his air gun and we used to go to that little park. It wasn't developed properly and we used to shoot things. Well, not animals, but you know.
Things.
Yeah, that's okay. Sounded. But now, look, when in Delhi, do as the...
I don't know which park you were in or what you were doing, but that's not the park I was
so
around.
It's Panchil Club in the evening and in the morning you behave like a ruffian. Yeah.
Okay, so that's really... that's crazy.
I swear I didn't know this. This is pure coincidence. Karmic.
Yeah, this is pure karmic coincidence. Yeah, so yeah, I did grow up there and... studied journalism, then very quickly moved away from journalism, did a bunch of things, but ended up in the media sort of space for the last 10, 11 years. I worked a lot with a broadcaster in Bombay. I was actually there for about 6 years. And then I moved to Delhi, came back and joined Facebook. And at Facebook, I work with a team called Partnerships, which basically works with creators, public figures, athletes, publishers, anybody who really wants to leverage Instagram to build their community or to monetize. And we try and help them as much as we can. And we're trying to grow that by even like not just working directly with people, but launching programs that we can do virtually. So whoever wants to sort of learn more about how to build an audience, we can support them. That's my quick pitch.
Oh, that's really quick. You're the least arrogant person I've ever met. Normally when you ask an Indian about their life trials, they always modestly tell you they don't want to talk about it. And then I just go and, you know, shave and drink something. And they go on for about 45 minutes about, I did MBA in BITS Pilani and after that I landed up in government hostel. Oh God, you have no idea. That was great. We can stop the show now. We're well ahead of the pack.
Awesome.
But yeah, just let's look now at you're in this place where the trends are such and happening so quickly. Sometimes I wonder how anyone can keep in, even the so-called Joneses can keep in touch with anybody else. For example, now we were researching something the other day to find out where X person was. We went on his Insta. Mm-hmm. I mean, I was like, God, it's almost like you're CBI now. All you have to do is track a person by tracking their, because it's the perhaps the most honest a person is, you know, in a sense.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty amazing how authentically people share. And I think it's also to do with the generation, right? I think you touched upon it briefly, but I do feel people growing up, especially folks who've grown up in the last 10 years, right? Somebody who was maybe say 14, 15, 10 years ago is 25 right now. They've grown up with this explosion of social media and they see it in a very different way. It's a lot about like being very upfront, sharing what's really happening in their life and kind of like being fairly unfiltered, if I can call it that, right? Where they want to actually make sure that it's a very authentic take, which is great, right? I think it really makes you connect because at the end of the day, people follow people, right? Why would I follow somebody on a social platform? It's because I connect with them and that can only happen if it's authentic. So I think that becomes really critical. Like you try and,
Sorry, but no, yeah. Nehal, what boggles my mind is growing up as an insincere person all my life, it was all about lying and not leaving a trail. You know, when I used to work at MTV, I would say, no, but I've got this radio commitment. And then through them, I would say, no, I've got this event I've got to do. It was all lying. But now I can't lie because if I don't have the Insta account, some other joker has it and I'm in his bloody Insta account. So my worry is that it's like the walls are caving in and Big Brother's watching and everybody knows everything. And what happens to people like us who selflessly dedicated our lives to being insincere and dishonest? Now we're just getting caught all the time. I can't even have an affair. My wife's like, oh.
So listen, I don't know if it's about Big Brother watching because it's very voluntary, right? So you are trying to share very voluntarily on where
But it's
you
also
are.
Become like something that you have to do, right? So whether Big Brother's watching or not, you can't stop yourself. So you're shooting yourself in the foot sometimes, I'm saying.
Yeah, I mean, I get the point. I think there is a certain tension about, am I going overboard? Or sometimes you feel like you've just constantly got a phone attached to your hand and you're trying to shoot or vlog through everything. So the balance is important. And we are seeing more and more people talk about that now where they do switch off, they do take breaks. And we highly encourage that because at the end of the day, this is about like long-term sort of, you know, building your presence online and you have to be comfortable doing it. Overdosing on anything doesn't really support that, right? So, you know, I think one, it's a different way in which people are growing up. They're using technology really much as an enabler. Like it's a way to really connect with communities. It's like somebody sitting in, like we have one of the creators in Nagpur today who does this amazing food, sort of food account, right? Now, how is he going to build an audience in Delhi or Bombay if he's not like going out there and sharing who he is? But the opportunity is there. Like the fact that this person can sit in Nagpur and build a global or definitely an India-wide community, that's huge. So it's kind of like looking at the opportunity, but then figuring out what your controls are to balance it for yourself.
So there's not to get too serious, but there's like a balance between the two in the sense that you've got the guy who's trying to create presence because he wants to generate income, okay? Which
correct.
Is anybody who has a chance. And then there's the other guy who's killing time, okay? Where lots of us louts just hang around with a long journey. And that's where the unnecessary information comes in, which again, people don't seem to introspect when they're doing that nobody cares. But you know, you're stuck between, let's say, Mumbai and Ahmedabad on a trip. Or something, and you give unnecessary information about everything around you for the next 3 hours, which is shameful. So I'm just asking you, is there a point where the marginal utility of the product sort of goes haywire, yeah. And we just are like,
no, I mean, that's
it's a, like alcohol, you've just done too much of it.
No, but that's a great point. So I think there are different types of people who join the platform, right? Some of them join because they want to just share with friends and family, which is great. And sometimes there is oversharing perhaps, but you know, that's just their only goal. Their only goal is to just be there for friends and family and maybe follow a few accounts they like. Some actually want to build a life. Like you said, they want to build a career of it, right? Which is work as a creator, as we call it, and try and really build a brand around their personality. And they obviously do it in a very, very structured manner. Now, the good thing is that given just the kind of number of creators we're seeing and the kind of, you know, number of like accounts that are coming up, the folks that are not able to engage or capture attention kind of will end up not really doing as well, right? Because a lot of it goes on engagement. So if you're not creating stuff that people are relating with, or if people are feeling it's way too unnecessary or it's not worth my time, then that naturally kind of starts not doing as well. And it kind of gives you that hint. So either you can pivot or you can just move on to the next thing. So I feel like there is a natural sorting of sorts that will happen thanks to the way the algorithm also works. So
it's like Darwin's theory of evolution of the fittest.
In a way it is. I think creators actually are amongst the most hardworking people I have seen, because they have to be on their game, right? And they're constantly figuring out what their audience needs. And the audience is changing too. What worked last year does not work this year in COVID, because now people are home and the whole system is like kind of upturned. So you have to be like kind of innovating. And if you're not, you know, that doesn't work either.
So now that you bring it up, so COVID is good for the social networking family?
I think there are two things.
Okay, right? Terrible thing to say. You know what I mean? I know, you know, you don't want to endorse that. Somebody will loop it and say, look what she said. COVID great for us. More COVID. No. That's not what I meant.
I think it's been a pretty dumpster fire of a year for everybody. But I think social media has played a really good role in connecting people when they're feeling really lonely. So I think what I really thought was
It was a luxury for some people. It has to be.
I mean, also because, you know, you're craving connection at the end of the day. Like if you're staying home and you're alone, and like you're lucky if you're staying with family, there are lots of people living alone.
What are you saying? That's a terrible thing to say. The same family, 6-7 months, nobody's happy. No member of the family wants...
So in the early part of COVID, you were very happy staying with family, but there were people living alone and there were people sort of dealing with really serious things and having the chance to connect with people, including your favorite like artists, right? Like we did a bunch of concerts at that time, which was called Live in Your Living Room, where people just performed on a Sunday evening just to give you a break from the monotony of your day-to-day like nothingness, right? So I think that stuff was really awesome. I felt like a lot of people came out and were very generous with their talent to like do things online for free just to get people excited and going. We saw a lot of stand-up as well. We saw a lot of people doing, you know, just performances. But more importantly, it's also a place where you can actually get information, right? So we have a COVID center that was there on Facebook as well as on Instagram. There's lots of resources that we share, which is about the correct information that you must look at if you are sort of searching. And people are sort of, you know, using it to also kind of continue their journey as creators, because you don't want to, you know,
lose out.
You don't lose out. I mean, you have to keep earning.
We've left out the most important thing on Insta, which for me is something that I think it's almost sinful that we didn't mention it. Yes. Cats. Without cats, there is nothing. What are you saying? Every day I get a cat video sent to me. Say, and the person is like beyond, I mean, you made them so happy, you have no idea. And it's a cat screaming. You know, just, oh, God.
That's awesome. But I mean, I hope, like, I'm all for more animal content. Okay, so I'm like, yes to cats, yes to other baby animals. All of that is a big yes. So, yeah, I think people want to see cute things, which is needed, I guess, at this time.
Yeah, I think old people like me shouldn't try to criticize. At the end of the day, we hypocrites watch everything. And I also love the animals. I love dogs on their back or falling when jumps. And there was this one weight training thing that was going around of people working out at home. And all they do is get injured. It's really mean, actually, from one perspective. But couldn't stop laughing. It's just great fun.
So
that's there. We'll take a quick break. And when we come back, can we quickly get into the whole strategic sort of role? Tell us how you make the big bucks, how much equity you have at Instagram, and whether you'll be standing for elections in 2023-24. All right. A quick break and we'll come back in a second. Yeah.
Filter coffee is a fascinating beverage. You need to pick the right beans, blend them in the right proportion, roast them to perfection, and slow brew at the right temperature to get the perfect cup. Which is exactly like great conversations as well. You need to track down the most interesting minds, get them into their zone, and settle down for an unhurried, unscripted chat. And coffee for me is always, always, always best enjoyed with friends. I'm Karthik Nagarajan, and do share my table as I meet some of the most interesting people I know and sit them down for a strong cup of coffee and an even stronger conversation. Join me every Wednesday for a freshly brewed episode. This is not Frappe. This is the Filter Coffee Podcast.
All right, we're back here with Niharika, Niharika Pandey without the Y.
Yeah, thank you. My God, I should like
Pandey.
Make my ringtone or something. Awesome.
Because what happens is we have the two Pandey brothers playing cricket, just to bore you for a second, and all the non-Indian commentators say Pandey. It's great fun. And Hardik Pandey coming in to bat at number 5. And I'm like, oh, Pandey? That's it. There's no way they can say. So the Y and the E is lost on the Occidental. Personalities of the world, not to use any racist terms, because all colors matter, especially in Insta. All right, so what is this strategic marketing thing exactly? It sounds very like, you know, highfalutin and all that, but is it for Insta or is it for me on Insta? Who are you talking to?
So it's actually, that's a great way to put it. It's actually, we are the, like, this partnership team that I'm part of. We work as the voice of, you know, creators or public figures or anybody who's sort of trying to build their presence on Instagram. We are the voice for them internally, and we're the voice of Instagram for them externally, right? So we are kind of the bridge between trying to really make sure that they get what they need, and we're able to kind of really make, ensure that they also have, like, we are plugging in feedback from India to product teams. So what that means on a typical day is that we work with a lot of the top public figures or creators or, you know, anybody who's trying to break out, and we give them, you know, best case practices. We help them with a lot of product knowledge. So we kind of share a lot of updates that are coming up. We just launched something called Reels. Very excited about that. So we do a lot of training around things like
that. What was that you just launched?
It's a feature called Reels, which is for short form video. I don't think you've created one yet because I stopped your account on the weekend.
God, I don't even handle my account.
Yeah. So we can talk about that later.
Yeah.
But it's like short form video. And it's about really making sure that we're bringing the best of what we can offer to this community, to India, and also sharing feedback, because India has a lot of different, if you're building something in the US, there's a lot of like local feedback we can share, which is different, right? Which is like, this will work, this will not work, all of that.
So you're advising the guy online as well?
We're trying to make sure that they have the latest information. So what we do is we work with a set of, like, because it's a small team, we can, you know, one-to-one work with a smaller set of people, but we're trying to do a lot of online programs. So we have something called Born on Instagram, which is basically a virtual program that we run for anybody who wants to be a creator.
So it's a tutorial for people like
it's
me.
It's a mix between a tutorial and like a masterclass. So we do a lot of like...
No, you're just saying masterclass. We don't feel bad. It's for students who have to catch up. Otherwise, all the other guys think they know too much about Insta. Oh, I know how it works. You know, what about us?
But trust me, the creators do know a lot. So I think they actually know how to hack things way, like they're ahead of the curve. But so it's kind of like making sure they know all the best case practices, but also working with them on, what's coming up next, making sure that we share like a lot of, like, it's a lot of community building as well, because creators themselves, like, they are also very close to each other. So we try and make sure they get mentors. They try and get, support from us when they need it. Sometimes it's just product support, right? They have a bug, something's not working, all of that. So we try and hold that connection together. Very exciting.
But everybody says it's like a young man's game. And I mean, you're talking so quickly and so many different points, and I'm unable to absorb more than, like, you know, maybe the word the or and or something like that. And I'm distracted by the paintings in the background, which must be costing Instagram a lot. How do you stay ahead of the curve in terms of the younger people who come in? I'm not talking from a job point of view, but just the fact that, you know, the world evolves and, you know, at some point, are you sure you know what the trend is?
That's a great point. I think, honestly, I don't think a lot of times it's the people who are actually actively creating that tell you what's really trending. So my role is not to be the one who decides here's a trend and now everybody must go do it. It's actually to make sure that the people who can create and who are the ones who are sort of really thinking about this day in and day out, they are most equipped to do what they have to do. Because, you know, it's a really interesting dynamic. And I think, like you rightly said, like, you know, we have creators who are as young as like 18, 19, 20, 21, who are doing this 24/7. So they know like the latest tips and tricks, and they have so many ideas. And it's really exciting to work with them because they are the ones coming up with ideas to us. So then we are like, okay, here's how we can help you make that happen. So I think it's more of an enablement role where we let them take the lead and make sure that they're able to do exactly what they want to do. But the way I try and keep myself a little sort of on top of it is literally by just spending time with them, because there is no other way. I think you can be a big consumer of content, but you know, the magic is really happening with people who are the ones.
Because
who
it's sort of like an organic thing, isn't it?
It is.
It's like an animal that's just creating itself also. And so I don't know how one can play catch up for, you know, for someone like me who's.
Exactly. And you never know what's going to break out. So our role especially is on the organic side, like you rightly said. So anything could break out. So if you see the entire Rasora, you know, song that broke out with Yash Raj, I mean, it was amazing because it was just something that somebody creatively put out, and he's been doing some really good music for a while. But that one particular thing just went crazy. Like his account, I think, you know, I think now it's hit over a million follows. That particular sort of asset itself has done really well. And I think these are things you can't predict, right? Hindsight, you're like, oh, okay, I can explain why this happened. But nobody could know how big that's going to go. And I think it's foolish to try and, you know, pretend that you do. So idea is that, you know, you have to make sure that you create the best, you have to ensure that you create the best ecosystem for it to happen. Can I enable it? So can I make sure they have the best tools, they have a really strong community, they have access to, you know, interesting products, and then the magic kind of happens on its own.
Oh, hindsight, listen, I'm the king of hindsight.
Yes.
There's nothing better than hindsight. I love hindsight. This is what happened after. Fabulous. But can you, again, mean question to ask, but can you give us a small, like a pressy pointer thing on how to start on Instagram and like get going? Is there some inside information that could help?
Yeah, absolutely. So I think there are a bunch of things we always recommend. First is figure out what you want to do. So are you really someone who wants to create an account so that others follow you and you become this brand? Or are you doing it just for friends and family? Because if you are, then they're two very different approaches. If it's friends and family, go ahead, do your thing, just have fun with it. If you want to be a creator, then be very clear about like, what is your vision with that? Like, are you looking at a specific genre? Are you looking at a specific sort of, is it lifestyle? Is it food? Is it dance? Like, just figure out sort of where you want to go with it. The second thing we always recommend is being consistent. So, you know, what happens is when you start, you have this blaze of energy and you're like, oh my God, I'm going to do this all day, like all stories, IGTV,
exactly.
I'm just going to be all over it. And that, like, that dies down in a week, right? So
true.
The idea is that be like conscious of that, you know, pick a schedule you can stick with, even if it is, I'm going to post like 3 times a week, but I will do it like consistently. That's way better than having this blaze of glory sort of, you know, first 2 weeks. The third is, you know, we have a lot of different features within Instagram. So we really encourage people to use all of it because everybody uses Instagram differently. So today I might be someone who loves looking at stories. I know you don't, but you might really.
Finally, you called me old uncle from Panchil Club.
You just said you don't like to see what people are, you know, doing.
No, it's just that they go on and on. It's just mundane after some time. I'm in airport waiting for plane. I mean, really? I mean, why?
But like, for some reason, I love seeing it. So like, yeah, exactly. So,
really? You like seeing the day-to-day moment of some third cousin of yours?
I don't know. It's something very, it's like getting a peek into someone's life. So that's interesting. Maybe I'm just like voyeuristic.
No, but if they meet someone interesting, say, oh, I bumped into Shah Rukh Khan, Tang. Okay, that's something to look at.
Like every day.
Yeah,
so.
But then he's sitting on a plane, he's sitting in a car, he's sitting somewhere, he's walking out of the terminal. What the hell are you showing me?
But you know, we are trying to like make that fun, right? So you can use music in the background, make it a whole moment. So yeah, there are ways to make, even like spice that up. But yeah, so for example, I hypothetically love stories. You might like IGTV, which is like longer form video. Somebody else might actually like Reels, which is a short video. So idea is to also get creators to try and do as many different features so that you can catch people wherever they are, right? So the first would be figure out what you want to do, be clear about what your vision is. Second is be consistent. And third is try all features. Make sure you're cross-playing with each other. Like if you put something up on stories, talk about it on your feed. If you put something up on IGTV, you can promote it on stories. There's a lot of cross-promotion you can do within Instagram. So like leverage that really well. I know it might sound like a lot right now, but it's super simple.
It sounds like too much for a pea brain like me.
It's really easy. And it's actually really fun to do because you're really making sure that, hey, you've done some really fun work. Like you're obviously proud of what you're doing. So you want as many people to see it. So it's like when you create a film, you go out and promote it everywhere, right? It's kind of like that. You've created a piece of work. You want to make sure as many eyes are on it. So go ahead and promote. And it takes time. So the last point is stay the course. It will take time, but the rewards are great. And, you know, if you build a community from scratch, like it really stays with you. I think that's the beautiful thing about Instagram. We have seen people like creators who've grown from really small accounts to big accounts today, and their community has seen that journey. So they really travel that distance with you, which is amazing.
Wow. You know, it sounds like marriage. Because basically it's a day-to-day grind, whether you like it or not.
It's a strong relationship. No, I agree. I wouldn't like...
Even at three posts a week, it's a proper consistent relationship, more than most things in your life if you look at the week with anything else.
It's a commitment for sure. So, absolutely. That is something that you can equate it to.
So, before we go into the AMAs, who are the big stars on Insta for you? Are there any people who you particularly like? Or I know cats and dogs, of course, but other than that.
No, I mean, there's a huge burst of like really awesome content. So one, since you have not checked out Reels, I'm going to mention a few accounts that are doing
it. God, you're really promoting this. You're good at your job. I'll say that. That's all we'll get out of the whole show. Reels.
I'm going to make
Reels in Gurgaon and Panjshir Park. These are the three highlights. You can't miss that.
All right. So, so on Reels, we have a bunch of guys who are doing like fantastic work. There is an account by this girl based in Bombay. Her name is, the account name is The Mermaid
Deepika Padukone? No.
I'm talking creators. Yeah. So her name is The Mermaid Scale. The account name is The Mermaid Scale. She does these incredible, meany, sort of really fun, fun content. We have, of course, Kusha Kapila, who I think is killing it on Instagram in general. I don't know if you've seen her content, but she's damn funny. She does really good, like, smart content. So really love what she's doing. There's somebody else called Saloni, who's just come up a lot, especially in the last few months. She does a lot of these sketches. So she does something called, she does this one with Kangana Ranaut. She does one which is
Impressions.
Yeah. And she's like really funny. She's, that's great sketches.
But Kangana is funnier. Being Kangana.
Oh, and she's also on Instagram. So
okay. You win everything. How dare you bully me?
You can go there. Well.
Superb. Well done.
Yeah. And I have to say, because you started by saying that, you know, that there is an ageism in it. Our fastest growing account, which is one that launched, I think, just 2 days ago or 3 days ago, is... Sir David Attenborough, who's gone to almost 1 million in 4 hours.
And who gave the tooth of that Megadolon or whatever to the young princess to be. That's what I saw. Okay. He presented them with a tooth of the ancestor of the great white shark.
Yes. So it's amazing. And his account is brilliant because it talks about climate change and it's giving a lot of great factual information. So yeah, my point is there is something for everyone and every age.
So we must fight this ageism. We should not let the youngsters bully, because they're bullying us. Just the way they look at you, the body language. And like my daughters had the cheek to tell me, how dare you be on Insta? You should not be on Insta. You should be on Facebook. I was like, you can't do that. This is, what is this, South Africa apartheid? You can't do that. You can't put me behind a barrier. All lives matter.
Exactly. So my point is, yeah, I mean, the fact that this was the fastest growing account, it beat Jennifer Aniston. It beat like a lot of bigwigs to be the fastest growing account. So it means that clearly there is a space. So.
Also, Niharika, people don't understand that a whole generation like us, 80s, 90s guys who grew up then, have a rebirth now, trying to catch up, because you probably didn't take it seriously as it started. And of course, there's a generation which is born into it. And so it's just their DNA. But for us, it's almost like a new toy. Yeah. It's like suddenly, wow, we've now rediscovered it. So for us, these refresher courses that you talk about, I think will help as well.
Yeah.
Self-guidance, because we don't listen to anyone, can't listen to old to follow instructions. But sometimes a trial and error seems to work the best.
Trial and error, and just like, exactly, right? I think what we always tell everyone is, see what interests you. Like before you're a creator or anything else, you're actually a user. You're somebody who is on Instagram and you know what works for you and what doesn't. Like what is boring and what is really interesting, and kind of look at the cues yourself. So yeah, absolutely. Spend time, figure out what works for you, try a few things, but don't be afraid to like to try, right? I mean, try all the features.
And above all, get yourself a cat, because when in trouble, you always have a post ready.
Yeah.
All you need is a nice...
I think COVID has taught us you need a pet. Okay. Whether it's for your own mental peace or for content.
On my Insta, I'm offering exchange your relative for a cat, which is a special offer. You bring in your old relative, we'll dispose of the relative and give you a kitten. I think that's a great offer.
That sounds like a really good offer, by the way.
Yeah? Worked in North Korea till he suddenly realized that he may feel hungry. Stop. I apologize. Let's go back. All right. Last question. And this is the most ridiculous Miss India question. I apologize for asking, but we have to. What's the future? What's next for Insta?
Like we said, 10 years is making us sort of look back and kind of think through all the awesome milestones that have happened. Personally, we're just excited about being part of the journey in India right now. It's been growing really, really well. And I think there's a lot of excitement about what Instagram can do for this generation of younger creators. So we're very excited about that. And I think just trying to continue being the voice of like, I don't know, like pop culture in some way, right? I think Instagram really holds that place where it's moving that forward. So we are just excited to see how we can keep shaping it, especially here. Because
also, as of now, you're not owned by China, so you're good to go. I said it, not you. Don't worry. You don't have to react.
Yes. So far, so good. That's just
Are you ever worried about competition?
I mean, I think there's a lot of competition, first of all. And I think competition is actually quite good in most cases. I think it's good to have competitors who are doing really cool stuff and who are keeping you on your toes and making sure that they're creating stuff which, you know, people are resonating with. So personally, I always feel it's better to have competition than not. And I think it keeps us
also really, the government. Huh.
Yeah, so that keeps us also like, you know, making sure that we are pushing forward. And there's a lot happening in the space. I mean, there are lots of new apps. There's a lot of places where, you know, people are trying to like, I think the idea is we are here for the long term. We really focus on like building things sustainably. So I think we are very clear on our path. And I think we don't want to like get too distracted by what's out there. But it's great to have people or apps or, you know, new services that kind of keep you on your toes. I think that's always a good thing.
Neharika, I'll just leave you before we go to the EMAs. Yes. I hope you join us with this. This is my gift to you.
Okay,
because you're perfect. A girl from Panchil Park, so we have some sort of common. My cousins are from
exactly,
there. So, I just want to leave this. You have Instagram. I'm giving you this is my invention. It's called Outstagram.
Okay.
It's where you take all the nonsense your friends send you and you dispose of it. You create a bin, an app which is like a bin, and you can just press a button and you dispose it without actually deleting. It goes there.
Yeah.
So how about that? That's my gift. The copyright I'm giving to you.
Oh,
you can enjoy it, make millions.
That's amazing. I'll make sure I update my paintings once I get me that billion.
But you're not giving me a commitment. Yeah. I want a commitment. Are you taking it or not? Otherwise, I'll have to go to your competitors.
It's definitely in consideration. Give us some time to like...
God, you sound like a government servant. Delhi DNA is coming through now. Huh? No straight answers. All right. Listen, you've been wonderful. I'm sorry to pull your leg and talk rubbish, but we couldn't find anyone more credible to talk because the recession has hit the podcasting industry. However, we do have the EMAs where our 3.5 listeners will send in probably, you know, what cream to use during lockdown, that kind of thing. It's very innocuous.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another awesome week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. I'd like to thank our sponsors this week, Intel. So Justine Royal came on Storytellers and Storytellers this week with Vineet. It was a really interesting conversation. Do definitely check that out. Hamsini Hariharan is back on the Pragati Podcast after an extended absence. Hamsini was one of the original hosts along with Pravan, but she was unable to continue. But we're glad to have her back. She's talking about her experiences since she left. She's been studying in China. Definitely check that out. You'll enjoy that. On Pulia Bazi, they discuss the revolution of 1857 as seen from contemporary eyes. Definitely give that a shout. I think you'd love that as well. Abhijit Ganguly was on Cyrus Says a couple of weeks ago, and he had such a great time, and we were so happy to have him on that we asked him to join us for Cock and Bull, and he was on this week. Do check that out. And lastly, I'd like to mention our Tamil show. We've been doing a show called Kadai Podcast Ponniyin Selvan, hosted by Kavita Jeeva. She has been phenomenal. She's rewritten the stories in a way which really, you know, they speak to a modern audience. But Ponniyin Selvan is over, and she has started a new story, though. The new story that she started is Sivakamiyan Sabatham. I'm sure I mangled that pronunciation, and I'm sure you'll love it if you're a Tamil speaker. Do definitely check it out. And with that, let's get you onto your show.
Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me. Here he is. Here's a big fan. See, his age group is better. Antanish Silvery, are you there?
Hey, man. Hello, what's up?
First, tell me, Harika, how much you like Insta?
All day, every day. I was there right now. I wasn't paying attention to this conversation.
That's the what?
Perfect.
Wow, superb. What an endorsement.
Ask for? Yeah, exactly.
All right, the first question, get to the EMAs. The first question comes in from Ananya Malik. This is quite a fun one. She asks, hi, Cyrus, hi, guest. Thank you for reading this question out, Silvery. Okay, you're welcome. I'm a long-time listener of the show. So glad that you guys haven't stopped during the lockdown. Cyrus, I have a serious problem. I am addicted to Haldiram's Bhujia Sev. I can finish one big pack a day by myself. Other Haldiram's products are good too, but Bhujia Sev is just out of this world. The way Amit loves Diet Coke, I love Haldiram's Bhujia Sev. Sorry, Amit is our founder. He loves Diet Coke.
I'm standing outside right now.
Yeah.
Talking to my wife for some reason.
Huh. The way Amit loves Diet Coke, I love Haldiram's Bhujia Sev. Can eat it all day long. Also, hate it when you off BS, that is the Bhujia Sev. But there are no sticks inside, those spicy sticks. So I'm truly addicted. It's my drug.
Yeah.
Which brings me to my questions.
Hmm.
How do I curb this embarrassing but harmless habit? And will the NCB arrest me for abuse of Bhujia Sev, like abuse of drugs? And three, if I were to find a boy who loves Bhujia Sev as much as me, do you think that would be a match made in heaven? Thanks, guys.
Well, my biggest worry here from a digestive point of view, being of that age group, is what goes in has to come out. So with Sev, be very careful, you know, what you prescribed or taking. But let Niharika take this question. Do you think they'll the Narcotics Bureau will come after them? Because we're not quite sure. They went after some oil. Next there will be some penis cream. I don't know. People aren't clear, basically.
People aren't clear. I think we'll have to wait and watch. I don't know whether Pujia makes it to the list, but I do also similarly worry for her digestive system. But maybe she's younger and can handle it, so that's great. But if she finds a guy who likes it as much as her, I mean, I don't know. I'm not sure if that's a match made in heaven, or maybe she needs, like, I don't know. You have to share.
Hey, don't, you guys, this is not so innocuous as you think. Huh. I don't know whether you're married, Niharika, but let me tell you that if you have food habits which are similar, it can help and go a long way as the marriage starts fading, because you have that to cling to. Listen, you got to have something
to cling to.
Yeah. That's when your eyes light up, not the anniversary. You both look at each other and Pujia, and you know, everybody rushes to the door. It's like a Shah Rukh Khan, Kajol moment kind of thing will be created. Lighting will happen. Cats will perform on Insta and boom, everybody's happy. So I think it's as innocuous as it sounds, yeah?
I'm just going to say one thing, guys.
Oh my God. We found the guy. We might have found the guy.
Yeah, I think I am that guy. I might be.
You wrote in as a woman.
Yeah.
Social networking, I just can't get my hands around it. Boy.
Sorry, for only listeners, I was holding up a packet of Haldiran Bhujia Sev.
Yeah, and he wasn't wearing any.
This is a very meet cute, podcast meet cute situation happening.
Just keep begging sponsors to come on. They just keep rejecting us. We even putting out a call to the NCB. They can sponsor us. This is brought to you by Narcotics Bureau Department, whatever. But even they have said, you know, well, they've not said anything yet. Damn
but
it.
I'm quite invested in the story. I think if this is like, if she's writing in about, hey, could I meet a guy like this? And there's a guy who's literally holding a packet of bhujia. Like, that's pretty exciting.
Hey, come on, Niharika. You watch food shows. Your Insta is filled with food things and all that. It's a huge part of someone's life.
Exactly.
Disregard it.
No, I'm not disregarding. I'm saying this is happening. Like, this needs a follow-up. Like, maybe you should reply back to the girl saying, I am that guy with the bhujia packet. And I don't know.
Okay. Sure. We'll do. Ananya,
she's matchmaking you. I didn't get that. So you become shadi.com.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah,
well,
she's my Seema auntie.
She's auntie Seema. Yeah, Seema auntie. Wow. Yeah. Are we all fans of Seema auntie?
Yes. Absolutely.
Oh, great.
I feel like that would have been, that's awesome.
I still think, in spite of all the criticism about racism and this and that, things that she's a sexism, that I just found her really nice. I hope nobody attacks me. But as a person, there was some like real motherly qualities about her. I would have gone to her and then, of course, had another bad marriage, but that's not the story. Niharika, are you applying online?
I'm married, so I think that ship.
So what? What stops you? Have you heard of Tinder, yaar?
Yeah, maybe.
Where do you think the name Silvery comes from?
Second time lucky. Yeah.
So what snacks do you and the hubby go for?
Oh, I think we actually have very different tastes in food, so.
Mm. Ouch.
Ouch, I know.
Is it like veg, non-veg?
No. But I mean, there'll be some like Venn diagram. I think we both like, let me think. I think, yeah, Asian food, I guess we both are.
I love Asian food.
Yeah, so I think we would find some middle ground, but he's far more like ghar ka khana, let's have like simple home food.
Oh God, how boring, yeah.
Exactly.
Ah, so. God, no. I like outside food.
Yeah.
Ghar ka khana. What kind of man is this? Very strange. Call Seema auntie right now.
I think I must. I agree.
Next one.
Okay, the next one comes in from Jogan. That's it. That's all the name there is.
Joe Rogan, Jogan.
Jogan. Hey, Saris and guest. My life depends on lying. I'm 20 years old, have two girlfriends, three groups of friends, a stepfather, so that means two fathers, which extends to having two houses, etc., etc. So, no pun intended, there are too many things in my life. All day long, I'm lying to everyone why I'm not hanging out / spending time with them. I'm always having to lie as I can't say that I'm with the other GF when I can't meet the first one, or that I'm with the other group of friends when I'm hanging out with the first group. It's come to a point where it's becoming difficult to keep track of all the lies and the parties that I have to please. What do I do? Please help. And before you say it, breaking up with one of my GFs is not an option.
America solved this problem, Silvery, when they came up with outsourcing. Sometimes you just can't handle things on your own. You know, in the past, I remember Bollywood actors in the 80s, because there was just 3-4 really big names. Then they had to use the doubles a lot. They really did. And they would really come for the closes because they just weren't physically possible to get the guy on the same set at the same time. So I think you have to outsource. You have to figure out someone who can perform the various duties that you need to. And hopefully he stays within the lines of what is acceptable behavior. Maybe a contract could be in place. Insta is always good for that. Niharika, we can Am I right?
They can have like private accounts. So they can
private accounts. You can't encrypt it or whatever the word is. You can't get into it. You can't crack it. And not a moral judgment. I'm looking at it from logistics. As logistics go, I think it just needs outsourcing. But Niharika, do you have another spin to it?
I think yours is a great answer.
You've lost interest in all mankind.
Not at all. I think logistics is the way to go. I agree.
Yeah, but why do we always have a moral issue about everything? Like this whole drug thing. Not a big fan of drugs personally, but I just can't understand. I mean, they smoke ganja or whatever twice in 2017. I mean, should we stop the country? I mean, really, what the hell's going on?
Yeah.
Sometimes, you know, too much moral judgment going on and too little logistics. Logistics means beds, vaccines, looking after people. I'm saying this, not you, so don't worry.
Yeah.
Because I know that all the networks have to play ball, apparently. In democracy, if you don't play ball, then, you know, people get hurt. Am I right? Yeah. Well, you don't say anything. Silvery, you say something.
Man, I'm just thinking that what if this Jogan is actually Joe Rogan and he sent in this question?
Yeah. Joe Rogan right now has transgender activists outside his house beating his watchman or watchwoman. But definitely one of the two.
Yeah.
He's under a lot of trouble. Spotify is about to release him. He'll come and work for us at the same negotiable fee as myself. Which is one painting which they've given me. That's about it.
That's awesome.
Yeah, there you go. All right, do we have time for one more or are we done?
Sure, one more.
One more, last one.
Last one comes in from Arushi Kadam. She asks, hey, Cyrus and guest. Massive fan of the show. I work as a risk analyst. I need some professional advice. I know it's difficult to give that during these times, but please try if you can. I am so sick of my job that I really need to quit. I've had a terrible year at work. I was thinking of quitting even before the pandemic hit. But then it did hit. And I got stuck with the dread of not being able to find another job. And I don't know for how long this is even going to last. But I feel this job is just not making me happy in any way, be it emotionally or economically. Nobody knows how long COVID is still going to continue. So what is one to do, especially if their job is driving them crazy during this time?
Okay, this is a bit of a sad question, Niharika, and true. They did an event yesterday and they were telling me how they had to let go of people and everybody's on a 30% cut and nobody knows when it'll be, you know, if at all it will come back to normal. So if he's telling the truth, it's a very sad story. A, he didn't like the job in any case, and now out of sheer desperation, you can't let go of the job. It's like having a really ugly spouse and then you can't, as you age, find another one. Metaphors are helpful, right, Silvery? Yeah. He's gone to sleep. All right.
No, correct.
What do you say? Because you guys are the one booming business. There are very few, maybe medicine, you, the pharma companies, and the media, to some extent.
It's a very tough spot. And I agree, like, if it is genuinely a true sort of situation, then it is very tough. I think it's very tough to kind of let go of anything stable right now. But having said that, I think it's also hard to kind of kill your spirit every day and do something you don't like. So only thing I can probably share is, if you think there's something else you want to do, this is also a time where you can do a lot of side gigs, like start trying something else on the side. Maybe don't give up the full job yet, but try.
Get an Insta account.
Get an Insta account. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, if there's a side hustle that you can start with, I think it'll just give you more confidence when you do need to make that switch.
You know, but let me quickly mention and plug you guys here unintentionally, which is I've had a few friends who've turned to making food.
Yeah.
And then they started selling online, okay?
Yeah.
Because there's no work for 6-7 months. So first they tried more like something to do. And now one or two of them are doing, one actually is doing really well. Just, you know, everybody's been ordering from him. He's actually making a serious amount of money and he may actually not go back to running his little shop post-December or whatever. So I think, and thanks to Insta and things like that, you do have a chance, a better chance, I would think, now than say 1980, if this was to happen. So you have that going for you. So let's tell this young man not to worry, but if he can figure out what he really likes doing and if he can somehow use the media, the social media outlet that is available. I don't want to plug Insta, so I won't say Insta, but he should use Insta. Is that fair? That's fair.
Perfect.
Yeah. And then because he's got nothing to lose. In any case, he hates the job. In any case, he may not be there when this thing is done. He might as well try. And we've had lots of people and upper middle class people should also understand that they need to pay bills and don't act like they have enough money that will never run out of. All that nonsense. End of the day, it's all of us. So I think we should just step up and accept it. Silvery, what about you? Are you okay with money?
Man, I would love more. There's no such thing as enough money.
But I heard you were selling some ganja outside Karan Johar's Dharma Productions. That was somebody else. Yeah, well, 3 years ago.
No, I was the one caught with 160 kilograms of weed in Delhi.
Oh, that was for weightlifting. Do you explain to them? It's cheaper than actually buying plates and stuff. Yeah. No, but jokes apart, I think, Niharika, that's a great point. You can actually have a parallel career without any pressure and you see where it goes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
fingers crossed for
this. She's not too enthusiastic. No, I can't believe it. Studied it again. Lost interest in the whole business. Damn it, I wanted to be in the circus.
No, I agree. I think we've seen a lot of examples, especially during lockdown, where people have just turned like passions, started off as a passion, but kind of went bigger. And it's awesome. Like, I think if you can try, and it also gives you confidence to not just cold turkey quit something, right?
So you can get, Niharika, whatever you're selling online, supposing it's like a product, you can actually sell 20, 25,000 things. You know, I mean, the numbers are staggering if you were to do well, which you could never actually do just sitting in a shop, for example, with cake. Yeah. This guy's selling cake, basically. He would never be able to do that in 1985. He'd be sitting there with five cakes in a shop.
Correct. Businesses are booming on Instagram, and we're very excited about that. And I think this is the time where, at least in all the bleakness of COVID, like, I think social media is helping them sort of.
So, Miss Pandey with an E, can we sell Antariksh, also known as Silvery? You think there's a market?
Nah, I'm not sure about the market, but it's definitely against guidelines.
It's good Punjabi stock. Ask in Gurgaon. I will make sure. Baba, what is your age? 24, na?
28.
1 weekend and 28. How much did you smoke?
What? It's always 38.
You
always
last week you were 24. 4 years don't jump. Jump 1 year, na? I can't get you a marriage proposal. Call Seema Aunty and I'll have to deal. This is going to be very complex. You'll have to be NRI.
All roads lead to Seema Aunty, basically.
Yes, yeah. She is the answer to India's problems. I've been saying that.
That's a t-shirt.
When will Arnab put her on the panel? You know, that's the only way we will save the country.
Yeah. God, yes.
Seema wants to know. All right. Listen, Niharika, this has been fun. Great fun, I hope, for you, but for me.
Thank you. It was awesome.
Yeah. And more power to you. And we'll be watching, tracking your career as you head Insta into the future.
Thank you very much, Cyrus. This was awesome.
Kehne mein kya hai? Doesn't hurt.
Okay, all right.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter, on Cyrus Says In. Or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
How many times have you motivated yourself to improve your sleep or lose weight or be more productive? How many times have you failed? Hi, my name is Ashton Doctor. Tune into my show, The Habit Coach Podcast, where we focus on creating small, tiny habits to improve your life instead of those big, impossible tasks. So make listening to me a habit every Monday, Wednesday and Friday on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com or on your favorite podcasting app.
माणसांना गोलगप्प्यासारखी असतात. हाय हॅलो करताना वेगळी आणि बोलताना वेगळी आणि गप्पा मारताना वेगळी. मित्र झाली की वेगळी आणि शत्रू म्हणून वेगळी. थोडक्यात दिसणारी वेगळी आणि असणारी वेगळी. कधी आंबट, कधी गोड, कधी तिखट, तर कधी चमचमीत आणि कधी कधी हॉट अँड स्पायसी सुद्धा. आणि म्हणूनच गप्पा, सॉरी गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर फक्त तुमच्यासाठी दर बुधवारी आयव्हीएम पॉडकास्टच्या ऍपवर, वेबसाईटवर किंवा युट्यूब चॅनलवर सुद्धा ऐकू शकता. तुम्ही आमचा पॉडकास्ट वेगवेगळ्या पॉडकास्ट प्लॅटफॉर्म वरती ऐकू शकता. फक्त सर्च करा गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर आणि आमचा पॉडकास्ट ऐकत राहा.